What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the MyCommand plugin in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Have you ever wished there was a command that existed in the game that you think would make your own life easier? Sometimes, certain plugins can add different commands of their own, but if you're still missing that special something, then you can create that on your own using MyCommand. MyCommand is an all-in-one tool that allows you to create custom commands or functions. Working with this plugin can be a little bit scary at first, but it's actually quite simple, so let's go over how to get started. Head to the MyCommand spigot page and press download in the top right. And after doing that, just make sure to place this new file in an easily accessible location to use in just a minute. Next, head over to the Apex server panel, stop the server, and then on the left-hand side, click FTP file access and login. Find and enter the plugins folder, press upload in the top left, and then on the next page, you can drag and drop that MyCommand jar file that you just downloaded into the upload section. Wait for this upload to reach 100%, and then you can click on your server name at the top of the page to head back to the main panel where you can restart the server. Okay, so uploading the plugin was easy enough, but now you have to configure it, and that is where people tend to get overwhelmed. Most of the configuration is spent in the files of the plugin, so in-game commands aren't necessarily needed, but that doesn't mean that they don't exist. If you're interested in learning some of these options, we will have a list of them linked down below. As for any other links or list that we might go over today, don't forget to check out the description because they're all going to be linked there. Learning these specific settings for making commands are important, especially when unique formatting is required to make it work properly. Here is a list of the most common settings you will use with this plugin, as well as the variables. And finally, here are some options that you're going to be able to add to each configuration, changing things like permissions, error messages, and tab completion. Okay, so before we start making custom commands or functions, we need to create a new YML file to store all of them in. From your panel, stop the server again and head back into the FTP file access and enter that same plugins folder from before. Now you'll press on MyCommand, and once you're there, click Commands at the top and select New File in the top left. Give that file a name that corresponds to your command category and end it with YML. After that, this is where you're going to enter any of your custom commands. And once you're done, you can press Save and then head back to the main panel and restart the server. Of course, you can always come back to this file to add or change commands. Just make sure if you ever make any changes, save the file and then make sure to restart the server, or you can use the mycmd reload command to reload all of the changes. Now, if you need any ideas or examples, inside of the main commands folder, you'll see a file called examples.yml. You can press edit to the right to view all of the predefined commands. You can also choose to delete this file, but if you don't, any command that is in it can be used by players. There are, of course, more examples in the MyCommand wiki. Now let's go over some of the commands you can actually create to make your game life easier. You can use any command from any plugin to make a shorter command for them through two methods, an alias or the run command. For example, if we use the Essentials X warp system to a PvP arena, then we can create a faster way to teleport here using this setup. If you were to use the run command type, then you would do something like this. This example shows setting a VIP rank in a plugin like Luck Perms. Here, this variable will be the player's name because the LP user command requires that by default in Luck Perms. And as you can see, players with the server VIP permission node can execute this command, but that can be changed to anything you might need. If you want to get rid of the permissions altogether, you can just set the permission required setting to false. Another option is to create a rules command, which could be formatted like this. Every line will display in-game as text, and you can even add color codes for better formatting. To create a voting list, this is the format you're going to use. By linking a URL, you're going to be able to click on that text in the game, and a hover message will appear with the link that you put in the file. Each line for a voting site requires the open URL before the displayed text, then separated with a semicolon for the hover and actual URL. But of course, you could skip this step if you just want something like regular text with no link attached. The last one we're going to go over is creating a custom trade. You can make custom villager-like trades that players can use as a shop. MyCommand allows you to set max usage for a specific trade and grants you the ability to use any in-game item for trading using this format. If you configured the registered option for your command to be true, but it's not working, then instead of using the reload command, restart the server completely from the panel. Most of the time, that'll work, but if that fails, then you can try using the reload command, replacing the end file name with the specific file that you made the change to. If you set up a certain command in your file and it doesn't work, then double check you have a valid type and correct format of the function. I know that the formatting gets overwhelming, but just take a look through our examples or the examples on the MyCommand page to see if they're typed correctly. Honestly, that is just the basics of the MyCommand plugin. If we really went over everything that's possible, we would absolutely be watching an 8-hour video right now. The MyCommand plugin is a super useful tool for making custom commands that have such a wide range of options. With this plugin, the only limitation you have is your imagination. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.